I just can't get enough of this sport, Bob, and I imagine that it's the same for our viewers.
They love it, Jim. We'll soon be providing even more bloody images, thanks to our new fist cam technology.
Yes, it's amazing how many cameras you can build into a knuckle duster.
And look who's stepping onto the pitch.
Wow! A veritable Blood Bowl legend.
And what am I then?
A venerable Blood Bowl legend. Mm.
Ah, and do you remember Snake Sanders?
Yes, he was granted a hypnotic gaze after a Chaos Cup victory.
That's it. The gift proved his downfall because when he catches sight of himself in the mirror or a puddle, he gets rooted to the spot.
Not easy to handle that.
Blood Bowl annals are littered with the stories of teams who've gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splodge.
Face. The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
Down and quite stunned, apparently.
Oh, a few slaps in the face and anybody can wake up instantly.
strange that the lizard men don't win more matches. They've got players that are fast on their feet and others that are quite strong.
Yeah, but they've also got players that are weak and others that can't pick up a ball.
Yeah, I suppose we look at it from that angle.
So widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. Say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal.
People say that the lizard men were the first practitioners of Blood Bowl.
Yeah, I heard that recently. Probably explains why they're so good at it.
That's one regulation clobbering.
Thank you.
sent him down for a chat with the Astro Granite. Did you know that a skink devised a very special tactic?
No, what was it?
To avoid losing the ball, he swallowed it and then made for the opposition end zone. That little trick came to an end the day a troll got hold of him. He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean?
Was worthy of a black hawk.
You're telling me it'll take a while to get over it. He'll have a bit of trouble blowing his nose from now on. Now, skinks are about as stupid as you can get. Each time I played against them, they thought I was an opponent, when, of course, it was them.
Yes, I see. This job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department.
He's got the ball!
Too fast to tackle.
This player knows how to dodge and give free lessons.
Recent medical reports stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing, when you come to think.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent. People say that the lizard men were the first practitioners of Blood Bowl.
Yeah, I heard that recently. Probably explains why they're so good at it. Yep, upside down. That's one way to look at things.
Open the slapping box and gives rather generously. The referee's guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided.
Really? Wow. I do.
That lets his biceps do the talking.
Yeah, but from his opponent's point of view, it was a short conversation.
Did you know that a skink devised a very special tactic?
No, what was it?
To avoid losing the ball, he swallowed it and then made for the opposition end zone. That little trick came to an end the day a troll got hold of him.
And then followed by a clean uppercut. Well done!
strange that the lizard men don't win more matches. They've got players that are fast on their feet and others that are quite strong.
Yeah, but they've also got players that are weak and others that can't pick up a ball.
Yeah, I suppose we look at it from that angle.
You're out of here.
I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral.
Get it done. Get it done. I love you. Have fun.
Is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules? The player gets hold of the ball. Ouch! That punch knocked his teeth down his throat!
Yes, Jim. That's never a nice sight. That reminds me of when I took Griffith bits in the 91 final against Reichland.
Oh, yeah. You kneecapped him.
And do you remember Snake Sanders?
Yes, he was granted a hypnotic gaze after a Chaos Cup victory.
That's it. We get rooted down to him because when he catches sight of himself in a mirror or a puddle, he gets rooted to the spot.
Not easy to handle that. Job, his nose got in the way.
Yeah, otherwise he'd have got it full in the face. This, the player is really in the right place.
Exactly. It's really ugly. Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
One that won't be coming back in a hurry. He did him with the old, you look that way, I go the other.
That's a technical term.
It's in the handbook. Wow! I can tell you straight, that hurts. The heroes of law these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the heroes of law hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them. Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see
more often.
Oh, over there, some cute little elf beauties are selling Big Moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like Big Moot sandwiches?
Yeah, no way! A little elf beauty, yeah.
This player was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family.
As soon as he throws his first punch,
we know the opponent will be out for lunch.
Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. Noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck.
A mouthful of knuckle and then a mouthful of dirt.
Yeah, he went down face first. Skinks are about as stupid as you can get. Each time I played against them, they thought I was an opponent, when of course, it was them.
Yes, I see.
After that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down. People say that the Lizard Men were the first practitioners of Blood Bowl.
Yeah, I heard that recently. Probably explains why they're so good at it.
Nothing to say.
And I don't have any remark to add, my friend. Go, go, go!
Oh, calm down. Strange that the Lizard Men don't win more matches. They've got players that are fast on their feet and others that are quite strong.
Yeah, but they've also got players that are weak and others that can't pick up a ball.
Yeah, I suppose we look at it from that angle.
Now, skinks are about as stupid as you can get. Each time I played against them, they thought I was an opponent, when of course, it was them.
Yes. I see. The players are ready. Well, that's one with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
Thank you.
first half is over already.
It can't be.
Yep, they're heading back to the changing rooms.
Well, see you in a few minutes, boys. During the halftime break?
No, but some of them don't look as though they'll make it through the end.
Ah, good.
and do you remember Snake Sanders?
Yes, he was granted a hypnotic gaze after a Chaos Cup victory.
That's it. The gift proved his downfall because when he catches sight of himself in the mirror or a partner, he gets rooted to the spot.
Not easy to handle that.
Maybe, but I can remember marking his face with my studs. And we're off! Incoming!
Well, it is a violent sport. Did you know that a skink devised a very special tactic? To avoid losing the ball, he swallowed it and then made for the opposition end zone. That little trick came to an end the day a troll got hold of him. Hold still and then pow, right in the face. If it wasn't for the blood flowing from his nose and mouth, you'd swear he was having a rest.
There was a time when the colleges of magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusader Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium.
catch. Right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now. Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Hall one that's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week. Senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with. The lizard men don't win more matches. They've got players that are fast on their feet and others that are quite strong.
Yeah, but they've also got players that are weak and others that can't pick up a ball.
Yeah, I suppose we look at it from that angle.
Sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap.
And do you remember Snake Sanders?
Yes, he was granted a hypnotic gaze after a Chaos Cup victory.
That's it. The gift proved his downfall because when he catches sight of himself in the mirror or a toilet, he gets rooted to the spot.
Not easy to handle that. And don't forget, children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, these are seasoned professionals.
Well, one of them is anyway.
Seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard. What violence?
Yes, it's a great spectacle, Bob.
Ah!
hook was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me? It'll take a while to get over it.
Did you know that a skink devised a very special tactic?
No, what was it?
To avoid losing the ball, he swallowed it and then made for the opposition end zone. That little trick came to an end the day a troll got hold of him. There's one that lets his biceps do the talking.
Yeah, but from his opponent's point of view, it was a short conversation.
As soon as he throws his first punch,
we know the opponent will be out for lunch. Skinks are about as stupid as you can get. Each time I played against them, they thought I was an opponent, when of course, it was them.
Yes, I see. One that wouldn't be coming back in a hurry. He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean?
People say that the lizard men were the first practitioners of Blood Bowl.
Yeah, I heard that recently. Probably explains why they're so good at it.
Thank you. Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision.
He really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it.
Today's insight comes from Jaime Schnibble, coach and owner of the Goblin Lowdown Rats team. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the minors. And do you remember Snake Sanders?
Yes, he was granted a hypnotic gaze after a Chaos Cup victory.
That's it. You get rooted in downfall because when he catches sight of himself in a mirror or a puddle, he gets rooted to the spot.
Not easy to handle that.
Yeah.
Did you hear about the Evil Gits? The team that is made up of a mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen.
Open the slapping box and gives rather generously. You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal.
Hear about the Evil Gits, the team that is made up of a mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen. Sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap. Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Why are you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck. Skills. The ball is caught. You think you'll be able to get up after that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down.
Thank you. I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral.
One with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one. I think he's singing him a lullaby.
Well, that'll keep him quiet for a while.
Yeah, he's just stuck, not dead. Senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with.
Doping is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules?
He trampled on his head.
Accidents will happen. Onto the pitch.
Now some of them have it straight into their backs.
A logical defeat for a team that was just not in the game.
They couldn't get their hands on the ball, and that's what cost them the game.
Well,